Ladies and gentlemen, we interrupt our program of dance music to bring you a special bulletin from the Intercontinental Radio News. At 20 minutes before 8 Central Time, Professor Farrell of the Mount Jennings Observatory, Chicago, Illinois, reports observing several explosions of incandescent gas occurring at regular intervals on the planet Mars. The spectroscope indicates the gas to be hydrogen and moving toward the Earth with enormous velocity. Professor Pearson of the observatory at Princeton confirms Farrell's observation and describes the phenomenon as, quote, like a jet of blue flame shot from a gun, unquote.
In New York, October 1938, CBS aired a radio drama about a Martian invasion. Director Orson Welles had adapted H.G. Wells' famous book, War of the Worlds, for the radio. Most of the show consists of news reports on the ongoing Martian attack. It starts slowly with an interview with a leading astronomer. And nothing seems very wrong yet, as the interview is followed by a weather report and a performance of an orchestra for the listener's home. But while the story progresses, the reports become more frantic and describe several losing battles of the human army against the Martians.
Conferring with someone, can't quite see who. Oh, yes, I believe it's Professor Pearson. Yes, it is. Now they've parted, and the professor moves around one side, studying the object while the captain and two policemen advance with something in their hands. I can see it now. It's a white handkerchief tied to a pole. Flag of truce. If those creatures know what that means, what anything means. Wait a minute, something's happening. A humped shape is rising out of the pit. I can make out a small beam of light against a mirror. What's that? There's a jet of flame springing from the mirror and it leaps right at the advancing men. It strikes them head on. Lord, they're turning into flames. Now the whole field's caught up by the woods, the barns, the gas tanks of the automobiles spreading everywhere. Coming this way now, about 20 yards to my right.
Ladies and gentlemen, due to circumstances beyond our control, we are unable to continue the broadcast from Grover's Mill. Evidently, there's some difficulty with...
This example is often used to illustrate the power of mediated communication, since the broadcast reputedly led to mass panic. Newspapers report that thousands ran scared into the streets, and we get the idea that complete pandemonium ensued. This would, of course, indicate exactly what the magic bullet theory predicts. Immediate, short-term and uniform effects among the masses. However, scientists that study this incident, most notably Paul Lazarsfeld and Herta Herzog, actually found evidence that suggested a more nuanced picture. First of all, many people had tuned in long after the show started, thereby missing the introduction that explained it was a show. More importantly, they found that contextual factors had influenced the collective reaction. It was 1938, and the news media had informed their audiences on the potential of an upcoming war with Germany. So people were forewarned that a war might happen. Research showed that some who panicked actually missed the part about the Martians and assumed it was a German invasion that took place. Another important finding was that newspapers had probably exaggerated somewhat the widespread panic that followed the broadcast. Reality was perhaps less sensational. Yes, hundreds of thousands were frightened to some degree, but in reality most of them had not acted on their fear. No evidence of hysterical screaming masses in the street, no suicides by people who wanted to stay out of the hands of the Martians. Later, Lazarsfeld again criticized the magic bullet theory, this time together with Berylson and Godet, when they disproved the hypothesis that voters were persuaded to vote for Roosevelt because of his extensive campaign. These studies are examples of a line of questioning into the all-powerful media paradigm by scholars. They were systematically testing the magic bullet hypothesis and had been unable to reproduce the presumed effects in an experimental setting. Also, scientists found that often in cases of presumed huge effects in real-life scenarios, like the Martian scare of 1938, there were many other variables to take into consideration besides media influence. Because these critical notions were the result of a long list of scientific studies, we call this paradigm the powerful media put to the test.